OpenGL is hard to start, but after that it's extremely rewarding. So if you want to start this journey, here are 5 tips that will make your life easier, that you won't get just by following a tutorial. And the last tip will fix the problems with setting up OpenGL projects and linking to libraries. I spent my entire summer trying to learn OpenGL, and it really felt impossible at first, but after that, the process was extremely fun, and I have been doing OpenGL for over 7 years now, and made some very cool projects. So I have some things that can really help you, starting with the tutorials. I tried every tutorial there is out there. The beginning was very hard for me, so I tried to learn from every tutorial there is. I even got books, so let me tell you what works and doesn't work. LearnOpenGL.com is the most popular tutorial, and it's great. But once you get to 3D stuff, there is another tutorial that's way better. And it's this YouTube series by Jimmy King. He explains the 3D stuff visually, and I think it's mandatory you watch his videos. So I would say learn from both Jimmy King and LearnOpenGL.com. Now, regarding 3D, you'd also need to learn some math. And you can learn from 3Blue1 Brown with this series. All of the links are in the description of this video. I also bought books on OpenGL, and I read some online. They can be nice, this math book in particular. But I think you learn faster and easier by using online tutorials. I would say skip books for now. Now, if you are still struggling with the very basics, like I was, you can also check out my OpenGL course, where I spend more time on the very basics than any other tutorial to get you unstuck. So check the first link in the description for that. Now, tip 2 is literally a game changer for OpenGL projects, but for some reason, nobody talks about it. There is a way to set up OpenGL to report errors for you. So every time you make a small mistake, OpenGL will tell you. And trust me, this is not something to ignore. Because if you have 1000 lines of OpenGL, and a single line is wrong, you get a black screen. So you need all the possible help you can get. And for some reason, people don't show the modern OpenGL error reporting, while many of them still use the old weird way of debugging OpenGL. That's horrible. So back to LearnOpenGL.com. Go to In Practice and Debugging. Why is it so hidden? I have no idea. This should be the second OpenGL lesson. But now, skip the first part. And go here to the modern way of debugging OpenGL. You just have to copy-paste some code into your project, and that's it. OpenGL will just tell you whenever you make a mistake. And if you put a breakpoint here, and enter with the debugger, you'll be able to see from where exactly the error occurred. Note that sometimes, OpenGL will report the error late. So it may be from a slightly older function. But most of the time, the breakpoint will get you to exactly where the problem is. Now, there will come a point where you get past the very basics of OpenGL and get to advanced stuff. Now, when I was in that position, I kind of felt stuck. I didn't know what to learn next. You see, there were some advanced things I haven't learned yet, like shadows, but they were way too hard for me at that point. I needed something not too difficult for me to practice. But I didn't know what. So, tip 3 is to find challenges for you to implement that are not way too hard for you. You can search for OpenGL effects and render studies. And I made a video some time ago, where I showcase all the OpenGL things that I know about. So watch that to get some inspiration. But there is a very important detail here that if you don't do right, you still won't progress. So following a tutorial is great, but you'll really learn OpenGL the moment you do something yourself without a tutorial. Let's say you need to implement this water. Well, try to think how you can achieve that, and write the code yourself. If you have no idea, look for a water tutorial. But don't copy-paste the OpenGL code. After you understand how it works, try to implement it yourself completely from scratch. This is how I implemented guardrails for my game. All articles on guardrails were extremely hard to understand, so I just asked ChatGPT how can I implement guardrails, and with some help from him, I managed to implement them in the end. ChatGPT is great for things like this, so make sure you abuse it as much as possible when learning something new. And tip 5. This is something that many people don't agree with me, but I stand my ground. So when you use C++ for big projects, like using OpenGL and other libraries, you need a build system, like CMake for example. It will make adding more libraries easier, and 99% of people agree with this. What I disagree with them though, is learning a build system at the same time you learn OpenGL. So let me give you the full picture. You want to make 3D games, and you want to learn OpenGL for that. But to make the project properly, you also need CMake. So both OpenGL and CMake are hard, and we need both of them. Well, the logical thing to do is to not learn them both at the same time, but learn them one at a time. But here is the thing, you don't necessarily have to start with CMake. In fact, it's extremely boring and it will just demotivate you. Like you want to place a triangle on the screen, not have to deal with these weird things. So what you can do is start with OpenGL first and not care about CMake for now. How? Just take my ready-made CMA configuration, and it already comes with OpenGL and all the libraries that you need to learn OpenGL, like IMGUI, GLM, and also the error reporting I talked about. With it, you can just start learning OpenGL, and you can learn how to configure the project later. So check this video if you hate linking libraries. With that, we have no reason to not learn OpenGL today. If you manage to understand how to place a triangle on the screen, I promise that the rest is very easy. Now again, I have a course on the very basics of OpenGL. So basically, these first like few chapters of Learn OpenGL outcome are great, but they can be overwhelming. In this course, I spend a lot of time on these very basic things, so it's impossible you fail. And I do all the things I talked about in this video, like I have quizzes and some challenges, so you have to try things on your own, instead of just copy-pasting some code from a tutorial. And at the end, I give you a list of all the places I learned OpenGL from, so you can easily continue on your own from there. So check the first link in the description if that sounds useful to you. See you!